We need more of the power of your kingdom in this place, God. We need more of your fivefold ministry, God. We need more of your people who are filled with your fire, God. We need more worship, God, not just more songs, more worship, God. We need more anointed preachers and less motivational speakers. We need more of your truth, God, unwatered, undiluted, God. We need it pure, we need it raw, God. We need it the way that it was written, God. We don't need anything added to it or taken away from it, God. All we need is your word let loose in this place, God. Let loose in our hearts, God. All we need is the truth of your precious word, God. Just put into our hearts, God. I believe if the word of God is released, Lord, our hearts will grab a hold of it because our hearts were created to long for it. Lord, break through the boundaries and the traps and the confusion of our minds this morning and penetrate into the depths of the good soil of our heart, God. That we might receive the word. We might hold on to the truth, God, and not have it stolen or snatched or destroyed out of our heart, God, but that it would take root and bring forth a harvest, God, that would be worthy of you, Jesus. You died not in vain, God. You died for us. We want your glory, God. We want your glory, God. We want your glory, God. We want more of your fire, God. More of your precious outpouring, God. The rain of your glory, God, in this place. Lord, water every dry and thirsty person right now. In this room are those who are so hungry for change. Right now, God says, I see your desire that you want change and that you want more. And God says, I am about to bring my glory into your life right now, this very moment. I am pouring from heaven my presence into your heart. You are not going to be the same. Those of you who are thirsty, it's like you've run a race. And it's like you're trying to find someone to give you a drink. You're tired. You're broke down. You're weary. You're running. You're running. You're running. You're looking for somebody to hold out something that can help you and that can meet the needs that you have. And right now, God says, reach up to me, for I have the living waters that you are searching for. And if you drink of my well, you will never thirst again. Holy Spirit, come. Let us run hard after you in these last days. Gird us up, Lord God. Put on us, Lord, such a strength that we've never had before, such an endurance and a faithfulness that we can withstand all the attempts of the enemy to try to trip us up and trap us, try to get us to run on a rabbit trail here, to get us diverted over to this new detour there. Holy Ghost, give us GPS spiritually in our hearts. Lord, I release a spirit of discernment, Father God, on this place, that we would know lies when we hear them, that we would know untruth when we hear them, and that we would desire to have only Spirit, God. Touch this house, Holy Spirit. Touch this place. Touch this place. You are so worthy. Hallelujah, Jesus. Is he worthy of your love?
Amen.
We want more of you in this place. I wonder if there's anybody here that's willing to get on fire, willing to let the fires of God consume you from the inside out. I'm tired of people being on fire on the outside and not on the inside. I want to see people burn from the inside out, where circumstances don't mess with them, where people's opinions don't bother them, where people's sarcasm and ridicule and just the meanness of others don't change who you are on the inside, because you're burning on the inside out. Where you aren't easily offended. Where you can walk in forgiven. You can live with the love of Jesus. You're not manipulated by people. You can see what they need and not what they want. You can meet the need. Glory to God. Change us. Transform us in this world. As your word comes forth, as Pastor Gary brings your word, Lord, change it from the inside out. It might be a slow change for some, but that's because you're working on a lot of things inside. Because you're building a mighty man and a mighty woman of God who will be able to stand the test of time. Be able to withstand the fires and the wind that are coming, like the house that is built on solid ground. When the heaven and the earth is shaken, they will be left standing, God, because you have changed them from the inside out. You've established them. You put a covenant in them, God. And they know that the covenant is worthless If there wasn't blood that was shed to seal it, Jesus, you did that. So our covenant is forever. And we stand with you. Look at somebody and say, God's going to burn us on the inside. Come on. He's going to change me on the inside. Hallelujah, Jesus. How many of you are ready for the Word of God? Come on, are you ready to hear the Word of God without change? Come on, without saying it's incomplete, we need to add this, we need to change this for this day and age and this culture. I want the true Word of God this morning. Come on, I'm hungry. Look at somebody and say, I'm hungry this morning. Hallelujah. And I'm going to believe that Pastor Gary's bringing a true Word of God. Glory to God. Let's give the Lord a praise in this house. Come on, come on, let's praise Him. You are worthy, God. Oh, I didn't hear a praise. Come on. You're a worthy God. You're a holy God. And there's not like you, God. And we're going to shout it out, God. And we're going to believe that you alone are worthy, God. And you alone are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. Come on. Everybody give Pastor Gary a big hand on his birthday. Come on. He could be eating cake and ice cream, but he decided he would come preach. Come on.
Here's your mic.
His name. I don't go very far, so I can just put his here daily.
Hallelujah. I was glad when they said unto me, let's go into the house of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. I so appreciate the privilege and the honor that I have to come together with you guys. You guys are wonderful people. I love you. And Lord, we just thank you, God, for the privilege and the honor, God, that we have to come and testify of you and to worship you and to preach your word and to hear your word. God, it's so wonderful to be a part of the family of God. Lord, we ask that you would open up your word and we'll give you the praise for it in Jesus' name. Amen.